Hi, welcome to the channel, and today I'm going to show you all the things you need to know about section breaks in Word. And to do this, I'm simply going to show you how you can convert one page into landscape, and also how you can start your page numbers with any number you choose on any page you choose. I'm also going to show you how to delete your section breaks, which is also a really common problem. I've got a 5-page document up here, and I'm going to go to view and I'm going to select multiple pages so that you can see my document. Currently I have 5 pages. Now, section breaks literally divide your document into sections in order for you to put different functionality into those sections. For example, if we wanted to turn this page into a landscape page, you would simply go to the bottom of this page here, go to the Layout tab, go to Breaks, click on the drop down, and select Next Page Section Break. And then I'm going to go to the Home tab, and then I'm going to select this Hide or Show Formatting Marks. And that's really important, so click on that. And as you can see at the bottom here, we've got Section Break. That means the first 2 pages are now their own section, and the remainder of your document is another section. So then I want to convert this page only, and then the rest of my document remain portrait. So it means that I have to divide just this page into its own section. So go to the bottom of this page here, click, go to Layout, go down to Breaks, click on the drop down, and again select Next Page Section Break. Now, at the bottom of the page here, you can see we haven't got a section break. But if I zoom in, you can see we've got these tiny bunch of lines here. That's actually your section break. It's quite bizarre how Word won't enter in that section break if it hasn't got enough room. So now if we just select this page, put your cursor anywhere on this page. Now we've divided our document into 3 sections. Go to Layout, go to Orientation, click on this drop down and select Landscape. So as you can see, Word has turned those pages to landscape, but because it cannot fit all of the text onto the one page, it's actually made 2 pages. Now, one way in which you can solve that problem is to simply change your margins. So in this page here, if you just click anywhere, go over to your rulers. If you can't see your rulers, go to View and select Rulers. And over here, you can see there's a grey section and a white section. If you hover between the grey and white section, you'll see your cursor changes, click, and then you can drag that margin up, which will create more space on your page. And as you can see, because you've created additional space, then Word has pushed everything onto that one page, and you can quite clearly see now your section break at the bottom of this page and the section break at the bottom of this page. Don't forget, the only reason you can see these section breaks is because you've gone to the Home tab and selected this icon here. Now, if you print this out, these markers won't show. If I switch it off, you can see they've disappeared. Switch it back on and they will appear. And this is really helpful to know if you put a page break in, a section break, or even something like a return key or an enter key, and you're not quite sure why you've got an additional page. Now, if you want to delete a section break, you'd think that you'd be able to click and drag, select it and delete it. It's not quite as simple as that. Unfortunately, you've got to hold down your Command or Control key, select it, then delete it. And the same one with this one, Command or Control, select it and delete it. And therefore, you've got rid of all your section breaks. Another way to use section breaks is for your page numbers. And this is something that comes up all the time. So let's say, for example, you wanted to start your page numbers on page 3. Starting them on page 2 is easy, but starting them on page 3 is a little more complicated. Some people want to start that third page with the number 3, and some people want it to start with the number 1. Go down to the bottom of page 2, go to Layout, and again go to Breaks, and this time we're going to insert a section break again, as we said. So go down to Next Page, and then we're going to double click at the bottom of this page to enter our headers and footers. Now, what's really interesting about once you've put in a section break and going to the headers and footers, is you can quite clearly see here footer section 1 and then footer section two. And then you can see all the way along where your sections are. So let's go to headers and footers, go to page numbers, click on the drop down and select page number. I'm going to put my page number in the center. Then I'm going to click format. And then here it says start at. Click on the start at because you don't want it to continue from the previous section. If you want page three to start at number one, so let's say you've got a cover page and then you've got some kind of introduction page and you want to start at number one on page three, select start at number one and click OK. Then click OK again. And you can see what's happened is now we've got page numbers on page one and two as well, but they've started with their own numbers one and two, and then you've started from number one here. And then we can go down to the bottom here. We can select our page numbers. You can see I've double clicked on that page number and it's surrounded by gray boxes and just press delete. And we can now delete those page numbers from section one. And we've now got our page numbers starting from section two and starting from number one. Now, if we want this to start from three, once again, we'll make sure we've unchecked link to previous. If I click on it again, you can see this same as previous comes up at the bottom here. If I uncheck it, it will disappear. So that's quite important. So now we're currently not linked to this section here at all. So go to headers and footers, page numbers, go to page numbers again. I'm going to select them to the center. I'm going to format them and I'm going to take this to page three and click OK again. As you can see, we start from page three and we don't have any page numbers on page one or two. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.